Earlier polls did show that the race here in Minnesota between Biden and Trump was tied. Joining us to talk about the presidential race and other issues, Minnesota senior senator and top Biden surrogate, Senator Amy Klobuchar. Thank you so much, Senator.
Well, thanks, Esme. It's great to be on. I'm wearing my purple as well.
There you go.
And excited about the Vikings game.
We all are. Let me ask you your reaction to the latest polls. That's three polls. There was also another poll by KSTP showing a 9-point lead by Joe Biden. Your thoughts on Minnesota? Does he have it wrapped up?
No one ever has anything wrapped up, and of anything this year, it's about voting and everyone getting out to vote. But it doesn't surprise me. I felt it in the air, and I think, you know, Minnesotans expect a government that will work for them. They work hard. Our people work hard every day, and this government under Donald Trump hasn't been working for them. It's less safe. You've got the pandemic still rampant. He didn't get the testing out in time. We're now finding out that he had information he didn't disclose to the public. And when you're someone like me, when my husband got very, very sick with severe pneumonia, and you find out at the same time the president behind closed doors was telling Bob Woodward that it was deadly and was saying that he thought it was airborne, that really hits home and it's really personal. And so I think people are looking for change. They are looking for a president that's going to have their backs and competent and has had that experience of getting us through the last downturn, because it's about our health, but it's also about getting our economy moving again. That's why I'm really excited about Joe Biden and how he's doing in our state.
You know, there were 19 counties in 2016 that had voted for President Obama in Minnesota and voted for Donald Trump, some of them by significant margins, counties like Beltrami, Blue Earth. You know these counties well, you've carried them. What do you say to people in those counties right now?
Well, one of the things that is sort of an untold story is what's happening in rural America right now. And it's a combination of a very difficult farm economy and low commodity prices with a Trump administration that actually has given secret waivers to oil companies that have hurt our biofuels and hurt a lot of our towns in that way. And it's also rural health hospitals, not enough broadband. 15% of Minnesota's households don't have high-speed broadband. 144,000 households, really hitting them hard when kids are trying to work from home. And so there is a big story going on in rural America where they need some help. And I think that is why you're going to see better and better numbers, not only for Joe Biden, but also for Tina Smith across our state.
All right. Let's talk. We want to get to broadband in just a second, but let's talk about election security. There is that controversy with the president suggesting that people vote twice. There are a lot of concerns about a lot of issues with election security. You've been very much on top of this. A lot of the votes may not be counted until days after the election.
Right.
How concerned are you about election security? How concerned are you about that? And how concerned are you about mail-in voting?
Well, very concerned, but I do want to make a pitch here from Minnesota. We've always had one of the best election systems in the country. We still do. 46 days of early voting starting next Friday, as early as next Friday. So you have the choice of ordering your ballot now. I just did it. You can do it on the Secretary of State's website. And then you can either mail it, put it in the mail, and it's early enough. It's going to get there. Everything's fine. Or you can bring it to one of the ballot boxes at the early voting location. So despite all this disinformation that the president's putting out there, no, you can't vote twice. Everyone knows that. And also from Russia, we have now learned from not just the government, the intelligence people, but also from the social media platforms, that Russia is at it again with disinformation and trying to confuse people. So I say, just go to the Minnesota Secretary of State's website, get your ballot, either go in person with all the days of early voting, you're going to find a safe way to do it in person, or mail in your ballot. And that's what you got to do, and just not, we'll look at some of the stuff that you're seeing on the internet is lies that are put out there by a foreign government.
All right. Let me ask you about broadband, because you've actually been talking about this issue for years. It really does seem unfair, even cruel, that there are families that do not have broadband here, that have much slower internet or no internet at all. You've been pushing for this. We've seen some movement, but obviously not enough.
Yeah, this is just, to me, it feels like the pandemic put a big magnifying glass on what we already know is a problem. There's a story in Otter Tail County of a girl that, to do her biology quizzes, drove 40 minutes to a liquor store parking lot because that was the only way she could get the high-speed internet to do the quiz. As I said, 15% of Minnesotans don't have broadband. Think about that. That is, means that in the school districts, especially in rural Minnesota, there's kids that are still using a paper and pencil, maybe calling in day by day while their classmates are doing it over the internet. And this is easy to fix. We've got to invest, yes, but we can do this. Iceland, with all of its volcanoes and lava and ash, have hooked up every single area of their country to high-speed broadband. And I think we should be doing this now. That's why the HEROES Act, which passed the House, waiting on Mitch McConnell's desk in the Senate, that has significant funding for broadband. We should be investing now, doing what we can temporarily with hotspots, but making sure that every family in Minnesota is on an equal playing field. It shouldn't depend on your zip code if your kid can learn or not.
All right. Well, Senator Amy Klobuchar, it's always a pleasure. Thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thanks, Esme.